Before the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic, visitation was booming in all Uganda's national parks. But this declined tremendously following various measures meant to stop the transmission and spread of the coronavirus from humans to wild animals in the park. One of such parks that was greatly affected was Bwindi Impenetrable National Park, the home to the endangered mountain gorillas.
COVID had a huge impact on us, on operations, and of course the communities were so much affected. People lost jobs, their poor were surviving on these parks for their daily bread, and because the parks were closed, you can see how bad it was.
Just like other parks in the country, Bwindi Impenetrable National Park shut down following this pandemic. So what did this mean to the people maintaining this park and the neighboring communities?
We know we have people called porters. We have over 400 porters in our park, and all of them were home. No, nothing to eat, no coin to, in terms of revenue, so they were affected. I can give you an example of Rafiki, that's the silverback of Kuringo that was speared to death. The person who killed Rafiki, he confessed, he said he had gone to look for something to eat, and he was not going to kill, he didn't go specifically to kill a gorilla.
For communities around Bwindi Impenetrable National Park, tourism has been their lifeline. They generated income from selling crafts and wood carving, basketry and weaving, and honey selling, among others. Others worked as cleaners, cooks and waiters in tourist lodges and hotels. With the absence of tourism, such persons became desperate. They were no longer able to earn from tourists. Some, especially former poachers, were tempted to re-enter into the park to poach.
People are really hungry. With the absence of tourism, they're no longer able to earn from the visitors who come to track the endangered mountain gorillas. And so they're only left with not very few options, and many of them may decide to return to the park, having been convinced to get out and lay down their tools and join the Kayonza Reform Poachers Association. And what we're really trying to tell them is, we want you to keep remaining out of the park. How can we help you most? With livelihood projects so that you don't have to enter the park? And how can you convince other poachers not to enter the park during this critical time, especially with the COVID-19 pandemic, where people are much more tempted to enter because they're not getting any funds from tourists who are coming into the park? So we're pleased that we're able to help in this very desperate situation at Bwindi.